internal resistance of cell. Internal resistance of cell. We represent it by small r. We have represented by small r. What is an internal resistance? When you draw a current from any cell or battery, in external circuit, current flows from positive terminal to the negative terminal. Does it mean when current reaches at negative terminal, it terminates? It does not flow. If I agree with this statement, then another important fact about the flow of current in the circuit is, current always flows through a circuit when circuit is closed. And closed means when it is forming a closed loop. So what actually happens in case of the cell? When you connect some resistance, say across this, these are two electrodes, positive and negative, and there is an electrolyte filled in this cell. In external circuit, current flows from positive to negative, and inside it, charge carrier moves from negative to positive. That actually forms a complete loop. When these positive and negative ions of an electrolyte moves through an electrolyte, their motion is obstructed by what? Other molecules, other ions. Therefore, an electrolyte also obstructs the motion of ions. In another way, we can say it opposes the flow of current. So we can generalize, an internal resistance of a cell is the position offered by the electrolyte of a cell to the flow of current. How does internal resistance of cell impact on our working? Internal resistance always gives a big impact on the output of the cell when you are trying to withdraw the current from it. Normally you go and buy a lithium cell and other cells from the market. These cells are always marked with EML, that is maximum potential difference. As I told you earlier, the maximum potential difference in open circuit is termed as EML. When you connect these cells and batteries in the circuit, the output is never equal to 6 volt if it is 6 volt marked, and if it is marked 9 volt, then it will never give 9 volt. It is always less. And this less output is because of the internal resistance of the cell. So when higher be the internal resistance, lower be the output. So we should take care that the internal resistance of a cell should be very low, or as low as possible. Second important thing, that internal resistance of the cell is always taken in series with total external resistance. I repeat, the internal resistance of a cell is always taken in series with total external resistance connected in a circuit. Now, what are the factors on which internal resistance depends? Number one, separation of electrodes. If electrodes are far apart, then ions have to travel larger distance and their motion is obstructed more and more, so internal resistance increases. Temperature of electrodes. When temperature of electrodes rises, internal resistance decreases. Nature of electrolyte. Concentration of electrolyte. Larger be the concentration of electrolyte, more be the internal resistance. That's why early days, I don't know whether you remember it or not. I remember, normally the car batteries are down in winter. Because due to fall in temperature, the concentration of electrolyte increases, therefore internal resistance increases. Area of cross-section of electrodes. What is an area of cross-section of electrode? It also depends on it. But remember here, it always depends only the area of cross-section of the electrode which is immersed in electrolyte. Not with respect to the area which is lying outside the electrolyte. Larger be the area, smaller be the internal resistance. So when you increase area, internal resistance decreases. Now practically in a circuit, resistance, internal resistance is represented in three ways. Representation of internal resistance. How do we represent in the circuit? Number one method is that we mark cell or battery symbol. EMF is marked positive and negative, and R is either marked down to it or above to it. Second method is you mark a battery or cell. Either you show internal resistance just connected with the negative, or it is connected with positive terminal of the cell. This is second way of representation. And the third, which is very commonly used nowadays, we are not marking anywhere internal resistance. We are simply writing value of EMF and R, or we can numerically, if you want to see, I can show you, it will be marked like 1.5 volt, 0.1 ohm as an internal resistance. Right? Let's see how to calculate internal resistance or expression of internal resistance. Expression for internal resistance. Consider a cell of EMF E, internal resistance R is connected with net external resistance R. Current begins to flow through the circuit, I. So I, you can define it current as equal to EMF divided by total resistance in the circuit. And as we know, internal resistance is always in series with external resistance. So it is EMF over R plus R. This you can write it as E is equal to IR plus IR. I into R by Ohm's law is V, So IE is equal to V plus IR. Therefore IR is equal to E minus V, and R is equal to E minus V over I. That's how you can calculate internal resistance. Right? You can also write this expression as V is equal to E minus IR. You see, this is a drawing voltage when you connect external circuit. This is maximum voltage, that is EMF, which is marked on the cell or battery. And this always reduced by this factor, I into R. So larger be the resistance, internal resistance, lesser be the output voltage. Let's see now. We connect two cells of different EMF in series, what will happen? We call it as grouping of cells. We have seen grouping of resistances, capacitors. Now we are seeing grouping of cells. Number one, series connection. So consider two cells of EMF E1 and E2 are connected in series, and their internal resistances are say R1 and R2. Current in the circuit is I, and as we know, current remains same. In series combination, current remains same, potential difference varies. So when you calculate potential across AC, let it be V. So AC, VAC is equal to VAB plus VBC. From the previous formula, we can write it as E1 minus IR1 plus E2 minus IR2. You can combine E1 plus E2 together, minus IR1 plus R2. This will be an equivalent EMF. This will be an equivalent internal resistance when you combine two cells in series. Right? So you can easily calculate. Say for example, if I say two cells of EMF 5 volt and 6 volt having internal resistances one ohm and 0.5 ohm are connected in series. Then what will be the effect? Net EMF given by this combination, E will be equal to E1 plus E2 as per the result. That is 5 plus 6 is equal to 11 volt. So if you want more volt and you have a lesser voltage, lesser EMF cells, you can connect them in series, and net internal resistance R will be equal to R1 plus R2. That comes out to be R is equal to 1 plus 0.5, 1.5 ohm. This you have to take, this should be taken care while you are combining two cells to form a series combination. You should not combine two cells which have higher internal resistance, because if effective internal resistance exceeds, then your output will decrease drastically. Let's see now when two cells are connected in parallel. Second is parallel combination. Parallel combination. So two cells of EMF E1, internal resistance R1, and another cell is E2, internal resistance R2, are connected in parallel. Current through this is I1, this is I2. What is same in parallel combination? Potential difference. What is different? Is current. So for the first case you can write V is equal to E1 I1 R1. V AB is equal to E1 I1 R1. Same with second cell, E2 minus I2 R2. Since potentials are same, so let VAB is equal to V. So from equation 1, V is equal to E1 I1 R1. This implies I1 is equal to E1 minus V over R1. Similarly, from equation 2, I2 is equal to E2 minus V over R2. Now, in parallel combination, I is equal to I1 plus I2. इन दोनों को जोड़ दो, उठा के add them, then I is equal to E1 minus V over R1, E2 minus V over R2. सॉल्व कर लो, चलो सॉल्व करते हैं. E1 R1 E2 R2 एक साथ ले लेते हैं, V तो कॉमन है, 1 ओवर R1 माइनस 1 ओवर R2. अब आप उसे एक्चुअल फॉर्मेट में ले आओ, V माइनस इज इक्वल टू E समथिंग I R1. तो इस टर्म को पूरा इधर ट्रांसफर कर दो, V ये आ गया R1 R2 R1 प्लस R2, ये आएगा आपका E1 R2 प्लस E2 R1 ओवर R1 R2 माइनस I. इसे डिवाइड कर दो, V इज इक्वल टू E1 R2 E2 R1 R1 R2 इंटू R1 R2 R1 प्लस R2 माइनस I R1 R2 R1 प्लस R2. ये कट गया, V इज इक्वल टू E1 R2 E2 R1 R1 प्लस R2 माइनस I R1 R2 R1 प्लस R2. ये आ गई इक्वेशन. अब यहां पर ये नेट EMF है और ये नेट इंटरनल रेजिस्टेंस क्या है, इंटरनल रेजिस्टेंस. अब वही क्वेश्चन आप एक बार फिर ले लो, मान लो दो सेल्स हैं, टू सेल्स आर जॉइंड इन पैरेलल. कर लेते हैं, एक मिनट का काम और है. एग्जाम्पल देख लो, टू सेल्स ज्वाइन करना है मुझे, इसका 6 वोल्ट है, इसका 4 वोल्ट है, इसका 1 ओम है, इसका भी 1 ओम है, या 2 ओम दे लो, चलो ठीक है, शुरू हो जाओ। तो नेट ईएमएफ कितना देगी ये कॉम्बिनेशन, ई इज इक्वल टू ई वन आर टू, ई वन ई टू आर वन, आर वन प्लस आर टू। ई वन कितना है 6, आर टू 2, 4, 1, 2 plus 1, 12 plus 4 by 3, that is 16 by 3 volt. You see, it is in between 6 volt and 4 volt के बीच। Internal resistance कितना आ गया, R1 R2 over R1 plus R2, ये आ जाएगा आपका 1 into 2, 1 plus 2, 2 by 3 ohm. That's how you can work it out for. Suppose 3 cells are joined in series and EMF versus voltage versus current graph is this. This shows say 9 volt, 6 volt, 3 volt, and the currents are here say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So what is EMF of each cell? 3 identical cells. Now when do we measure EMF? When current is zero. Current is zero at this point. What is net EMF? EMF net comes out to be 9 volt. Now this EMF of 3 identical cells which are joined in series. So net EMF in series is E1, E2 plus E3. Since these values are same, so 3E is equal to 9, E is equal to 3 volt. Right? Now 3 cells EMF gives current 6 ampere. Right? Now here EMF is 0. When current is maximized, voltage is 0. It means internal V is equal to E minus IR, E net, R net. Right? This is 0, external voltage. E is 9 minus I, resistance I is 6, R net. So R net is equal to 9 by 6, that is 3 by 2 ohm. Now since these cells are joined in series and cells are identical, so R net is equal to R plus R plus R, 3R is equal to 3 by 2 ohm. So each cell internal resistance is 1 by 2. This is another question.